Hello everyone,
welcome to a new video of the Indicator Store. Today we are going to learn and review what is and how to use the builder on NinjaTrader 8 so we can understand how it works and create any logic to automate the signals and also to backtest and optimize. So we go to New Strategy Builder. Here we have the option to create a new strategy or select one that we already have, or even we can select one of them and save us with a different name. On this case we are going to create a new strategy. We select a name. Here we select if it is working at bar close or at each tick. This is something that we can also, the user can change from the input parameters. But this is the default working method. On this place, we can add additional data. For example, if our logic uses not only the instrument of the chart where we apply, because a strategy works on any chart that we apply, any instrument or bar type. But if, for example, we need to use another instrument or another time frame, then we add on the upper part of this form. On the bottom is to add vector variables. This is not something that we use frequently, but if we need, then we can use that option. On today's session, we are not going to use any of these two options. Here is where we place the input parameters, where the user can specify a parameter, like for example, the period of a line, of a moving average, or the period of this oscillator, the overbought, oversold. If we are not going to use any parameter, then we can go to the following tab where we have conditions and actions. If we see that we need a parameter, then we can go back and add here the needed parameters. We can also use variables. There are some videos about the use of variables. But by now, let's start for something very simple. For example, here we have two exponential moving average. The red is an EMA 17, the other 34. And for example, if we want to detect the crossover between both of them, on the top form, we place the conditions. On the conditions, we can add as many tabs as we want. NinjaTrader calculates first the tab number one, then the tab number two, and so on. So it analyzes all the tabs, and if the condition at the top is true, then it executes the actions at the bottom tab. On the conditions, we could say that the red line crosses above the blue line. So here we choose indicator. This is an exponential moving average, EMA. This is an EMA 17, so we can place a fixed number, 17. With this option, we can select an input parameter, for example. On this case, we are not using variable, but we can do this later. And the condition, we are going to use cross above. And the other indicator is an exponential moving average, EMA of 34. We click on OK, and now we can see the logic. When the red line cross above the blue line, then, and also all the other conditions that we place here are true, then we execute this panel. The action can be to execute an order or assign a value to a variable or drawing something. The easiest drawing that we can select is to paint the background, right? Because we don't need to calculate the vertical position for a dot, arrow, whatever. Painting the background don't need any calculation of any place. So if we cross above, then it will be a long. So let's paint it on blue. And if we want to test this, we don't need to finish the strategy. We can click on compile. And now we can apply the strategy to the chart. We need to be connected for a strategy to work. Then we can click strategies, select the strategy that we are creating now. This one, we can see that there are no parameters. We enable, and now we can see the places where the condition is true. That way we can check if the logic is fine and what else need to be corrected, because for example, this crossover is almost insignificant because we need to add some kind of threshold, same here. Another option will be to check on an oscillator at the bottom and detect when we are on the oversold or overbought area. For example, this stochastic uses a period of 7. I am not using the D line, only the key. So let's say that we want to detect that when the key line is over 80. And so we can add another tab where we want to know when the stochastic is bigger than 80. So we add, on the left side we select the indicator. This is the stochastic. We need to select the same parameters. It is 7 for the key line, 1 for the D, because we are not using the D. The line that I am looking is the key. And on the condition is greater or equal. And now on the right side, I need the number. For that, we can look inside miscellaneous, numeric value, and there we can place 80. And when this is true, so we are overbought, we can paint something. This will be a cell area. So let's paint the background in pink or red. And then we can check if we can combine both logics into something that works. So let's set the background color to something reddish. Compile again. And now we can see the areas where the red key line, this one at the bottom, is over 80. Something that we cannot detect is when the two colors are overlapped. So let's paint something else. Instead of painting the background, we can paint the bars. So set the bar color to red. Compile and refresh again. We can reload NinjaScript, or another option is to, into the Strategies tab, we can disable and enable again. And now it should be painting the bar colors in red when there is an overbought condition. On this particular case, both logics are not showing something interesting. But for example, we could be interested when the red line is below the blue. This is a downtrend. Then we can be interested in a short signal. So let's change that. Instead of detecting crossovers, because the crossover only paints a bar, a signal. And let's say that I want to use this as a filter. So I want to detect all the places where the red line is over the blue. So instead of using crossover, I change this to greater. So the red line is greater than the blue line. The EMA 17 is over the EMA 34. But let's make this cyan to something lighter. Compile and refresh. And now we can see that it is painting all the areas where the red line is over the blue. So this is an uptrend. And these are the areas where I will be interested in entering a long. And so I need long signals. When long signals will be in this area, when we are oversold. So we can use these signals, the overbought signals, to create the oversold signals. So now we can go to the second tab. This is what is painting the candles in red. And I want the blue candles when the stochastic is less or equal to 20. To avoid typing everything again, I can duplicate the tab, right click, duplicate. And now instead of red, let's use blue. So those will be long signals. And on the stochastic, instead of greater or equal, is less or equal. And the number is 20. If we compile and refresh, now we can see the red candles and the blue candles. When the blue candles are here, when the oscillator is below 20. Now we can use the background as a filter and the color of the candles as an entry. So on this area, we only go to long. So here we have two longs. When it is not painted, it is a short area. So for example, we have a short here. And with this, we can do a setup because we already have this is, for example, a short. We already have the filter and the signals. Something that that can improve this is, for example, for the short signals, entering an overbought area is not enough to be interested in going short. Because market is just going up. A good signal will be when it is starting to go down. So it is overbought, but it starts going down. Or here, for example, it is oversold, but starts going to the upside. So it is starting to leave the oversold area here. How can we do this? We need to add a condition, another filter, that not only it is below 20, but it is also pointing up. So the current value is bigger than the previous value. Or the current value could be even bigger than 20. But let's add on these two tabs where we are painting the candles. Here, for example, when the stochastic is bigger than 80, let's say that we add another condition, that the stochastic is going down. It is bigger than 80, but it is going down. So we add the indicator is the stochastic. stochastic, the same parameters that we are showing on the chart. So 1, 7, and the key line. And on the right side, we need to place the same indicator, because I want to say that the indicator is going down. On the previous candle, it was bigger. So the current value is less than the previous value. The now is this zero number, how many bars into the past. So on the right side, I need to place everything the same, but one bar back. So I look for the indicator, stochastic, all the same parameters, 1, 7. The line is key. Everything the same. The only difference is that it is one bar back. So now, here, is less than the same indicator one bar back. If I compile and refresh, then all these red candles should be red only when the key line starts going down. It should be less. We should get less signals. Let's see what happens. Disable, enable again, and now we get a signal just on the place where we are interested. When the stochastic is starting to get outside of the overbought area. So now we can do the same with the long signals. On this case, this short is not executed because the red line is over the blue. This is area for a long. So we need to do the same with these blue candles. So we paint only when the stochastic is going up. So we can copy this condition into the second tab. We can copy and paste, so we don't need to write everything again. And now we only need to edit and change the sign. Instead of going down, it is going up. So now we edit and only change this from less to greater, and that's all. Now we compile and refresh, and now we get this, because this is just slightly going up, and this is a signal. We can avoid this signal by adding a threshold. But now, if we apply the filter to the signals, then the blue areas are places where we only enter long on the blue candles. Where it is not blue, like here or here, is a short area. So we execute shorts where the candles are red. For example, here and here. So now we are approaching to something that can be an interesting trade setup. Now we don't need the first tab. This is only for visual, because it is painting the background. We did this only for visual understanding of the setup. But for the reason of placing order, we don't need that tab. But this is a condition for long. The one that is painting the background is a condition for long. Now we can copy that condition inside the logic that paint the bars. So we can copy this and add this as an extra condition where it is painting the candles. So we can paste this. And now for the shorts, we can place the same condition, but invert the logic. Instead of the red bigger than the blue, the red less than the blue. So we edit this. Instead of greater, less. Now if we compile and refresh, now we only get long signals where the area is blue and short signals where the area is not blue. So now the signals are where we have an entry. So now this is ready to go to the following step, adding placing orders. We can also, of course, add input parameters, as we saw in previous sessions, because the parameters are what we can optimize. The parameters can be the periods 17 and 34, maybe the period of the stochastic to change it at 7, and of course, the target and stops. And also, we need to add orders. So to finish this strategy to make it work, now on this tab, indeed of painting candles, we need to place an order. When it paints the candle in red, we enter short. And when it paints in blue, we add an order to enter long. Click on OK. And now we are ready to continue to the last part where we add target and stops. The target and stop are only needed if we are placing orders. So we can add a target in ticks with a fixed number or an input parameter. In this case, we don't have input parameters yet. So let's add a target and a stop with 10 ticks. And now we are ready to finish. We click on Next, Finish, Wait to Compile. And now, if we refresh, we are going to also have executions. Refresh, and now we can see the orders. Don't forget to go to Data Series and enable the plot executions to be able to see those executions. And it executed all the orders, the two longs. One was a loser, the second was a winner. A short, a long. Here we have two longs. And another long. Hope this video has been useful for you. And if you have any question or comment, please post below. Thank you. Bye bye.